The miracle, Lerone Murphy, 10-0.
10-0.
This
bro.
Is what you do on home turf, isn't it?
This is what I do, man. I loved it. It was a good fight. Great experience for me. I needed the three rounds. Like I said to you in the interview, the three rounds would be perfect for me.
A few bumps, a few bruises. Still beautiful?
Still beautiful. Still beautiful. Always beautiful, man. I loved that fight, man. I loved it.
The first round was all you. All you. Clear round. Had everything your own way. And then suddenly we were in the trenches in round two.
I feel like I fell into a few. I fell into his game a bit, and that's his experience. He dragged me into them close range attack. I should have kept it long range, but it's a learning curve for me, man. I loved it. I loved it. I loved it every minute of it.
Those low leg kicks were doing tons of damage for you. You were switching to southpaw, and then he started switching to southpaw. That started throwing you off.
Yeah, I thought, I felt like he was trying to set something up, because obviously from people's tape, they see me throw the left kick a lot, so I thought he was trying to counter that. But I felt good, man. I felt comfortable in there every minute of the fight.
Guy's not got many losses on his record. Last time he did lose was to Peter Yan, the current champion down at bantamweight. You know, you're definitely moving in the right direction.
Now he's just lost to the future champion. I'm coming, man. Trust me. I'm working hard. I'll probably have a week or two out, and I'm back to the journey. Straight back to the journey.
Nice little message there to the other featherweights in this weight division, that if you take Lerone Murphy down, the man gets back to his feet and gets back quick.
Yeah, man. We've got the Dagestanis in our gym. I go through that day in, day out with the top grapplers in the country. So I'm well drilled.
Talk to me about the post-fight. First thing you do, you climbed out the cage, you made a beeline for Dana White. What was that all about? What did you say?
I just spoke to him, man. I said, thank you for the opportunity. Like, without this, what am I like? I'm just grateful for the opportunity. They give me three solid names, and that's been perfect for my career. I'm just climbing a ladder.
What does the rest of 2021 look like? Are you looking for maybe another two, three fights this year?
Two, three fights is perfect. In a perfect world, three fights. But if I get two, that's good for me. I only fought once last year, so I'm off to a good start this year.
Tell me about that tribute at the end as well. You dedicated to fighter Nana Murphy. Just give us a little bit of insight on what went on there.
Yeah, so my Nana passed away just before Christmas. I was in London in the quarantine. I had to watch her funeral from my phone, which was heartbreaking, watching all my family. Couldn't console him. So the trip was just a bit... I flew to Abu Dhabi on the plane, a bit down and stuff, but I'll come out here and got the win, and I'm sure she'll be proud of me.
How much of that was on your mind this week, and maybe even making that ring walk tonight, thinking she's looking down?
Yeah, she gave me a different fire, and I knew she was watching over me. I went into the trenches there, like you said, and I know she's looking down on me.
Still undefeated, upwards and onwards.
Yeah, man, always. Thank you.
Love it.
Thank you.
Good man.